views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Get fired up for Spirit Fire Radio, your guide to practical mindfulness and meditation. Join hosts Tim Darter and Steve Kramer and discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day. Watch yourself connecting in a whole new way and find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio. Now here's your hosts, Tim Darter and Steve Kramer.
Hello, welcome to Spirit Fire Radio. I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer. It's great to be with you today. We are on the step of the practice of living awareness called heart-mind. And so here on Spirit Fire Radio, each week, we take a step of the practice of living awareness, which is Spirit Fire's own meditation practice, and we invite a guest onto our show who embodies and in their life's work sort of is an emanation of the qualities of that step. So I couldn't be more excited for today's show, Heart Mind, as it's one of my favorite steps of the practice. We've worked with the lungs in the last couple steps with soften, open, and receive, and soften, open, and release, speaking of the lungs receiving the air and then releasing with an exhale. So all of this softness sort of naturally engages the qualities of the heart. And the breath obviously leads us to the lungs, and the lungs lead us to the heart. They are physiologically connected, but they're connected in so many ways. Heart-mind is a really interesting combination of words. In Sanskrit, that would be the word citta, and it literally means both heart and mind. And we're starting to see these connections in the West as well. In the East as well, the word sem in Tibetan also means heart-mind. And it's this word that is used to describe a whole system of thinking and perceiving. So that word perceiving is a little bit bigger than the word thinking. If someone is experiencing what they would call in Tibet low sem, they'll often point to their heart, and that would be the area that they are feeling this discomfort. In the West, we would call that a heavy heart, and we think of a heavy heart as having this perception of loss or a disconnection to our innate sense of joy or our sense of well-being. So the heart is this center. It's a source of compassion. It's a source of empathy. It's a source of union, of considering group as a notion. But most importantly, it is the source of forgiveness. The heart center and the heart is where we sort of move to vibrationally or energetically as we are considering forgiveness. And forgiveness is just becoming this key word in the West. We all have, I hope, in our lifetime, experienced the power and the clearing and cleansing that comes along with forgiving someone or embodying forgiveness. We see it in treatments. We're seeing doctors being trained in forgiveness techniques for a wide variety of ills, for cancer, for especially veterans with PTSD. We think of these veterans as men and women who have are extreme cases, have been living extremely with a sense of separation or contraction. To be in war, your survival is dependent on this us versus them mentality. And if one is in heart and in union, obviously in war, you would be in conscious contradiction to that vibration of union. And we see veterans in this sort of therapy processes of recreating their trauma and recalling their trauma for healing. And in that, they'll often rewrite the scenario. They'll sort of reenact this in a group, and there's group apologies and validation of the feelings that they have sort of bottled up inside them, this experience that is not only trapped in their mind, but in their heart. And so forgiveness becomes a big part of that. But there's projecting of this inner world into this three-dimensional space of group therapy that sort of allows them to rebuild this narrative. And it becomes then a narrative that provides feelings of acceptance, of forgiveness, of love. And the mind is so linked into that. So we're going to talk about that today with our guest. And I'm sure we'll get to thinking of seeing the mind as software. We think of the brain, the organ of the brain, as the hardware. That's kind of like on your computer, that's your actual hard drive. And the mind is the software. That's the operating system, the various programs and apps that our mind uses. And sometimes that software needs updating. So in these therapies, it's kind of like they are receiving a software update. And we see again the word soft. We think of soften and open, software being something that's open to being flexible and open to change. So today, our guest is Dorothy Stone. And she's going to talk to us about a really amazing technique called ho'oponopono. And this is an ancient Hawaiian technique that embodies this idea of forgiveness. So Dorothy, that was a long introduction, but I wanted to set it up because it's such an important step within the practice. And so welcome to our show, Dorothy.
Yes, thank you for that wonderful setup there, Steve. And I want to thank you and Tim and Spirit Fire Radio for this opportunity to speak about my experience with Ho'oponopono and to maybe give people out there who don't know of this practice a little introduction to this beautiful ancient Hawaiian forgiveness ritual.
And beautiful it is indeed. I have experienced it myself, and I can say it's powerful. It is powerful beyond belief, or actually to the point of belief. So I just love it, and I'm so excited to hear more from you. So tell us just a little bit about Ho'oponopono, perhaps a little
yes.
bit of history.
Yeah, well, it's has ancient Hawaiian roots, and the teachings are called huna, and hu means knowledge, and na means wisdom. And the kahunas are the guardians of the teachings. And Ho'oponopono is a forgiveness, a practice that embraces unity consciousness and really fosters a greater understanding of oneness and unconditional love. And you were talking earlier about your software, and it's really about this practice has allowed me, and I believe really allows one to recalibrate your consciousness to a higher frequency of energetic reality. So we're shifting into a higher dimensional awareness. And this is really about, you know, feeding our spiritual intelligence and, you know, becoming more present with that higher dimensional awareness. And the practice of Ho'oponopono really involves four sentences. The sentences, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you, and I love you. And what I love about the practice in these four sentences especially, and I think one of the reasons why I connected with it so strongly is because it's in our Western language. It's really a common understanding of compassion and action and unconditional love and action. And, you know, I've studied many different practices from in different parts of the world from indigenous cultures that involve transforming and transmuting energy. And, you know, some involve different languages and some can be kind of complicated in that way. And so I think this practice is, you know, we all know how to say I'm sorry and what that means, and understand what forgiveness is all about. So it's an ancient practice with its roots reaching back really thousands and thousands of years to high Vedic culture, and some say with possible connections to Atlantean and Lemurian roots. So it's also aligning with other ancient practices similar to Buddhist Tonglen practices and Peruvian Caro practices of Hucha Mikwe, which is, you know, moving and transforming energy. So we were blessed in this world at this time to have a kahuna named Morna that was responsible for bringing the practice forward in our modern Western culture. And she has passed, but had a devotee, Dr. Len, who really took over after her death and has the leadership of her institute called the Foundation of I. And Dr. Len stresses the purification of memories and any data that we've stored up that inhibits harmony in any way. So Ho'oponopono is really a way to resolve conflict and to really bust through our attachments to fear, doubt, and judgment.
And I love that, again, that word data comes up and sort mm-hmm. of busting through, because it's the tangibility of this practice mm-hmm. that just is so powerful. These four words, rather these four statements, which just have such an impact. And we're going to go to a break now. When we come back, I'd love to hear a little bit more about the vibration behind these very specific words and the powers that they hold for transformation indeed. So Dorothy, we'll be right back after a break, and we'll talk more about Ho'oponopono.
Another runner in the night, blinded by the light.
Transformation Talk Radio is dedicated to the education and awareness of Lyme disease.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm Dr. Pat, joined here by
Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
Dr. Pat Basile and Dr. Nusheen Darvish will be bringing the most innovative, groundbreaking information, research, treatment innovations, and stories from those it affects every day.
I'm so excited to be talking about this.
We have so much to share.
Dr. Darvish and I are planning to do is connect the dots.
People suffering with all sorts of chronic diseases, it's time. It is time for them to transform.
Tune into Lyme Talk Radio and help keep our mission strong.
For the loyal listeners out there that have been listening to this incredible show on Lyme disease, we are not going to let you down. We're going to come through stronger and enrich the platform for Lyme disease awareness through Lyme Talk Radio. The message will continue. The conversations will become stronger and the healing epic.
Hi, I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Join us on Spirit Fire Radio. Discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day.
And watch yourself connect in a whole new way. Find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio.
Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. for your weekly guide to practical mindfulness. And to learn more, visit www.spiritfireradio.com.
Radio. Find Your Shine with Kelly is the show that celebrates what makes you, you. Join co-hosts Kelly Wadler and Dr. Pat Basile as they break down how to brilliantly fuel and move your body and love what makes you shine. Kelly is a professional arts and wellness coach dedicated to helping brilliant women find their confidence, energy, self-love, and shine. Tune in to Shine On Radio with Kelly and find your shine on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Are you ready to thread your life with intuition? Intuit Apparel can help you do just that. This is not just about a piece of clothing. This is about a movement, an awakening, and staying centered in life. Your life. Intuitive and host of the radio show Get Into It, Lynn Brown, was given this image with the intention of a clothing line designed to represent the essence of life itself. Visit intuitapparel.com now and wear your intuition with
pride. Tune in to The Jen Royster Show, intuitive guidance to inspire your life, each Thursday at 8 a.m. Pacific and 11 a.m. Eastern on transformationtalkradio.com. This amazing show is an inspirational hour that will take you on an epic metaphysical journey to discover the spiritual approach to life's greatest challenges. Dr. Jen is an internationally known intuitive counselor, spiritual teacher, and energy healer. Call in for intuitive readings and visit JenRoyster.com for more information.
1230 WBLQ.
Hi, welcome back to Spirit Fire Radio. And before the break, we were speaking with Dorothy Stone about the forgiveness practice of Ho'oponopono, and we were going to get a little deeper into the four steps and the four phrases that are said.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit more about the nature of the practice. And I just wanted to let you know that Ho means to make, and pono means right or correct. So pono means rightly right. So essentially it means to make rightly right. And that really means to become into alignment with higher self and source energy, realigning the environment and reshaping reality. And, you know, it's so exciting to know that we all have the capacity to do that within this very simple practice. And we have an understanding that, you know, we know that everything in the universe is connected. We understand, you know, quantum physics. We understand the holographic nature of the universe, and that nothing happens outside of yourself. And, you know, this really gets into different layers of consciousness, and it can be a real paradigm shift. And so I wanted to just read a paragraph from Ulrich Dupre's book on Ho'oponopono, the Hawaiian Forgiveness Ritual. There are many, many books out there, and I love this one because it's so simple, and he's so eloquent the way he states things. And he says of this paradigm change that Ho'oponopono is a spiritual soul method of purification that cleanses us from fears and worries, destructive relationship patterns, and any religious dogmas and paradigms that oppose our personal and spiritual development. And he talks about how it clears out blockages in our thoughts and cell structures, for our thoughts are made manifest in our body, and that this is the major paradigm shift that we are embracing. So when we move into a Ho'oponopono practice, we want to get to that place where which is a place of recognition, and you know, that we are empowered, and, you know, move into that space of the courageous heart and wanting to come from this spiritually intelligent place and a peaceful place. And we think about, you know, whatever we're perceiving to be outside of ourselves, and it can be, you know, a judgment that we've made, any kind of problem that there might be, or a specific action or memory that requires healing. And we want to really search our heart for our share in this, knowing that we're all interconnected. and that we want to forgive unconditionally and speak these four magic sentences. I'm sorry, please forgive me, I love you, thank you. And then give thanks, express trust, and let go. So in the four sentences, I'm sorry is really apologizing and perceiving that there is suffering that connects us to our feelings, but that we're not going to reject the problem, but realize that you know, we're all in a learning phase and learning how to do this, and we're asking forgiveness for ourselves, but also our forebearers with which whom we're connected energetically, genetically, and within traditions and anything that may have caused harm, that we can now move through with the power of the spoken word and free up ourselves. And Ulrich Dupre says within the sentences, I'm sorry, please forgive me. He says, please forgive me for having, through myself or my forebearers, consciously or unconsciously, disturbed you and me in the course of our evolution. Please forgive me for having acted contrary to divine laws of harmony and love. Please forgive me for having until now judged you or the situation, and in the past disregarded our spiritual identity and connectedness. So it's really a remembrance of the fact that we are all connected, that we all have a part in creating this incredible earth journey, and that we can express love from deep within our hearts to every piece that we may have perceived as being outside of ourselves, and then being very thankful and expressing gratitude for the opportunity to move into this practice and to learn from every aspect of our lives and everyone that we come in contact with, and anything outside of ourselves that we perceive as being separate. So I particularly wanted to share a little bit about my first real experience with Ho'oponopono. And I just want to say that that was in a retreat, and there were many, you know, it was a group practice, and here we are, all this group, and we were, you know, I think having the perception that we were all somewhat spiritually aware, and this minor conflict arose within the group, and we were all kind of blown away by that, like, wow. Where did this come from? And now what are we going to do? And through the course of processing that conflict, we decided to do a Ho'oponopono practice. And so I got to see really up close and personal how powerful this practice was. And it was all very beautiful.
Why don't we take a break, and we'll be back right after these. Stay with us, everybody. You're listening to Spirit Fire Radio with Tim Darter and Steve Kramer. We'll be back right after these.
My My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true, so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
Each month, listen to Live More Radio with co-host Allie Katz. Join Allie and Dr. Pat as Allie introduces new ways to bring balance back to your life through meditation, sleep, and exercise techniques so you can live your truly authentic life. Stress less, live more. To learn more about Allie, visit ATOZENmeditation.com.
Introducing the Lucid Planet, a digital gathering place featuring cutting-edge, high-vibrational content that will empower and inspire you to become the greatest version of yourself. Visit the Lucid Planet today to stimulate your mind, body, and soul as you connect with a global community of like-minded people. The Lucid Planet is edited by renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly Neff, who is here to help you cope with anxiety, connect to your higher purpose, uncover your true passions, and live your dreams. Dr. Kelly's fresh, compassionate perspective emphasizes growth, transformation, healing, and thriving, even in the face of adversity. Say goodbye to bad news and low vibrational media for good and become part of the larger collective of people working together to navigate the global shift of consciousness and transform the world from within. Join the planet, the Lucid Planet. Visit thelucidplanet.com. Welcome home.
What does it mean to be healthy? For each of us, it means something a little different. Discover the art of herbal medicine, a natural way to help our bodies respond better to the modern-day stress and toxicity of our everyday lives. Using organic herbs from around the world, the skilled herbalists at Urban Wellness in Kirkland can help you choose the herbs that are right for your body. Find your herbal solutions for common health issues at urbanwellness.com. That's H-E-R-B-A-N wellness.com.
If you're one of the millions of Americans suffering from anxiety, you probably know how powerless and out of control this emotion can make you feel. This is why it is so important to remember that anxiety is created by your mind, which means that you can learn to use your mind to uncreate it. Hello, my name is Dr. Friedman Schaub. My award-winning book, The Fear and Anxiety Solution, provides you with a step-by-step breakthrough process to understand and resolve the root causes of your anxiety and build a solid foundation of confidence and inner peace. If you are ready to take your power back, visit thefearandanxietysolution.com. That's thefearandanxietysolution.com or call 866-903-6463. That's 866-903-MIND.
1230 WPLQ. Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice.
Welcome back to Spirit Fire Radio. After that break, we're here with Dorothy Stone, and we're talking about the ancient Hawaiian ritual Ho'oponopono. And she was talking to us a bit in depth about these four phrases that are used within this process. Those are, I'm sorry, please forgive me, thank you, and I love you. And these four phrases are used as this process to really engage one's psyche of everything that has led up to the moment and sort of taking responsibility for everything that might be outside of ourselves, creating that which is inside of ourselves, that being the heart, that which is outside, is a reflection of the inside. That which we have inside moves to become a reflection of our outer world. So much here about heart, mind, and this process. And Dorothy, I so appreciate you saying that you've experienced this power, as have I, of using these words. And actually, in my own sort of personal ritual, I use them by saying them out loud and sort of creating this vibration of them. And this tangibility within this practice is something I love. And you were talking earlier about how this is used within families, and it means it was, I believe you said, and I know this of the practice, that it was used within the Hawaiians as a practice to resolve conflict within families. And we're seeing this used on a broader term for broader purposes of forgiveness on a larger scale, and recreating these paradigms, and also that it becomes sort of this universal forgiveness, sort of shifting our relationship to become universal. And I just love that. So before the break, you were talking to us a little bit about your experience with the power of this process. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Your words are so beautiful, Steve. And I think that, you know, I was describing my experience within a group process, Ho'oponopono, and the Hawaiian, traditional Hawaiian teachings within their culture, they're often used, the Ho'oponopono practice within a family, like a family council, when there's conflict within families, to help heal any discord within a family constellation. And you know, when you do this practice and you're saying these words, you know, either silently or out loud, "I'm sorry, please forgive me, I love you, and thank you." They become so powerful, and it's really hard to not really increase your internal awareness. You know, when you're saying, "I love you," and you're saying, "I love you, I love myself, I see and respect the divinity within you and within myself. I, you know, I love and accept the situation just as it is." So you are giving gratitude for the opportunity to embrace a situation. And in the past, it could have been a situation, you know, where you have those experiences where, you know, something comes up and you just really want to run away, or you want to just plug your ears and not hear what's being said. But the Ho'oponopono practice allows you really to gain a certain level of empowerment, where once you can accept responsibility for your share through the interconnectedness that we all know is very, very real, then it gets a lot easier, and it really allows you to really experience more a peacefulness, and to have more of an experience of grace and gratitude in your life. So when we think about resolving conflict and see ourselves as connected and really unified and not in a disharmonic state of separation, it really brings us to unity consciousness, oneness, and unconditional love. And what an important thing that is for us to experience in our world at this
and I would say,
in time.
I would almost say that that's our natural state. You know, what I find interesting about this practice, and you were saying it a bit as we were leading up to the first break, is I believe it's our natural state to become one with this present moment and with the natural expansion of the universe. You know, I think that's where this quantum element comes in. And we know when we're in a place of contraction, or we've got conflict, we've got fear, we've got blame or resentment, we actually are resisting that natural flow. We're resisting this sort of present moment, which is naturally expanding. It's naturally a place of union and a place of togetherness. So what I find so transformational about this practice is it's kind of it's recalibrating to bring us up to this, up to speed in a way with the natural flow and expansion of the universe, which is all inclusive.
Really, we are in every way creating new neural pathways that are moving us away from separation and, you know, a dualistic view of reality. And I think that's an important thing to understand, and to also know that when you contribute to harmony through a practice like this, if you really discover your share, your part in disharmony, you really enter into a deep healing process. And to know that while we heal ourselves, that we're healing the world.
Indeed.
As we heal ourselves, we're healing the world.
Beautiful. So you were talking a little bit earlier about Morna's prayer. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I can, absolutely. Morna had she has a beautiful prayer. She was a very humble woman, and you know, according to my understanding, she worked in a spa in Hawaii, and she really Dr. Len connected with her because she was instrumental in bringing great healing to his daughter. And when I read this prayer that she said before she entered into Ho'oponopono practice, I really began to understand, like, wow, this is really way multidimensional, and this is way beyond what I thought it was. And so her prayer is, I'll simply state it. And it's Mother, Father, God as one, universal truth and light. If I, my family, relatives, and ancestors have offended you, your family, relatives, and ancestors in thoughts, words, deeds, and actions from the beginning of our creation to the present, we ask your forgiveness. Let this cleanse, purify, release, cut all the negative memories, blocks, energies, and vibrations, and transmute these unwanted energies to pure light. And it is done.
Very nice. Very nice indeed. And it is done.
How beautiful is that, huh?
It's really quite beautiful. Listen, Dorothy, we're going to take just another quick break.
Yeah.
And when we come back, I'd love to do a brief practice. Perhaps we'll even repeat the prayer and come back and do another practice. So how does that sound? We'll be right back.
Sounds great.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all, a healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. During the month of October, Dr. Darvish and the Holistic Medical Team are promoting Breast Cancer Awareness Month with 25% off breast thermography. Safe, painless, radiation-free, and accurate. Purchase your breast thermography screening for 25% off now until October 31st to receive this special. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Hi, I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Join us on Spirit Fire Radio. Discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day.
And watch yourself connect in a whole new way. Find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio.
Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. for your weekly guide to practical mindfulness. And to learn more, visit www.spiritfireradio.com.
Are you ready for a radical shift in your way of being? Are you seeking a more deeply connected and fulfilling life? Awakened Living Radio is a show dedicated to helping you embrace a life filled with profound peace, connection, and happiness. TJ Woodward is passionate about helping you find your clarity, balance, and purpose. Join co-host TJ Woodward and Dr. Pat Basile on the first Monday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific Time for Awakened Living Radio on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Tune in to the hit show Master's Chambers with your trusted friend, Connie Fife, Mondays, 1 p.m. Pacific, 4 p.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Each week, Connie will connect you with the best of the best thought leaders from around the globe to share their strategies and best practices. Getting better together. To book Connie, visit ConnieFifeSpeaks.com.
Tune in to Lucid Planet Radio with Dr. Kelly Neff. This hit show will illuminate your senses and empower you beyond your daily stressors and hardships. Renowned psychologist and author Dr. Kelly will captivate you with far-reaching topics and amazing guests as you wake to the greatest version of yourself. Learn to tap into your intuitions, think critically about our world, heal emotional and psychological wounds, and follow your passions to live your dreams. The Lucid Planet. Welcome home. Visit lucidplanetradio.com for more information.
1230 WBLQ.
Hey life, look at me. I can see the real time. 'Cause when you shook me, took me out of my world,
Welcome back to Spirit Fire Radio. We are talking with Dorothy Stone about Ho'oponopono. And what a powerful, powerful process to use these powerful terms. And before the break, we heard Morna's Prayer, which was just delightful, the vibration within this lovely prayer. If anybody and the listeners would love to know a little bit more about Ho'oponopono, certainly YouTube has lots of lovely meditations, lots of recitations of this prayer, and useful practices. I personally have found it just to be really something so useful and clearing. So Dorothy, yeah, this idea of sort of recalibrating and bringing ourselves up to this natural state of presence and of, I would say, of sort of recalibrating ourselves to a place of love, to a place of union with all of those that we may have had conflict with, yeah?
Yes, and the Ho'oponopono can be a mantra. It's like this magic formula. It's a meditation, and you know, it is a practice, and the more we practice it and the more we bring it into our awareness and into our lives, we really are creating those new neural pathways. We're flexing those spiritual muscles and altering our perceptual awarenesses. And, you know, the Huna say that the world is what we think it is. And I really believe that through practices like Ho'oponopono, these energy practices, we're really developing a fluency in the language of light. And I think about this language of light as being connected to all this photonic energy that we're receiving at this time. And it's something that is allowing us to expand beyond our three-dimensional awareness.
Indeed. I mean, energy follows thought, and these thought forms and these words, they hold a vibration and they hold a certain amount of light. And certainly when we hear that prayer or we hear these four sentences, you know, the vibration is so high, I can't imagine it not, in a sense, shifting our vibration, allowing us to hold that much more light.
Yeah, exactly.
So I'd love it if we could, on air, sort of experience this a bit, if we could just sort of experience what that process might look like for the listeners. So I know that you had said we could perhaps do that today.
We can, we can move into a little bit of a Ho'oponopono practice here.
Wonderful.
And what I'm going to suggest is that if you can move into, a space where you're physically comfortable and take a few deep breaths. And this particular exercise is really about, it's about non-judgment, but it's also, it's about not judging yourself, because really how easy it is for us to judge ourselves, and how easy it is. It's easier to forgive others, I think, than it is to forgive ourselves for whatever perceptions we hold about past mistakes or errors in judgment. So this Ho'oponopono exercise really focuses on that non-judgment towards self and really self-love. So I'm going to just briefly restate Morna's prayer and to go into this, the brief exercise. So as you get comfortable and allow yourself to breathe deeply and really move into a heart-centered space. And you could either really also breathe in some feelings of gratitude or appreciation, those coherent emotions. Infinite Father, Mother, God, universal truth and light, if I, my family, relatives and ancestors have offended you, your family, relatives and ancestors, in thoughts, words, deeds, and actions, from the beginning of our creation to the present, we ask your forgiveness. Let this cleanse, purify, release, cut all the negative memories, blocks, energies, and vibrations, and transmute these unwanted energies to pure light. And it is done. So I would ask you now to look into your past to find any mistake or error in judgment for which you cannot forgive yourself. Simply observe this from a distance and look closely at the event and appreciate it as something that has contributed to your learning process. Do not imagine that you could have been spared yourself this error, because if it had not come into your path, it would still be approaching you. Now, forgive yourself for having been annoyed about it for so long. Then say the four magic sentences and let go of it forever. And you can say the four sentences with me, or simply listen, or say them silently to yourself in whatever order you feel compelled. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I love you. Thank you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I love you. Thank you. Breathe in the energy and the power of all that is within our unified consciousness. Blessings to all.
Beautiful. Really beautiful.
Thank you.
So I can say that from experience, I have actually used that very same process, and I had no prior knowledge of Ho'oponopono and was in a situation that was just very sudden and very difficult and brought up quite a bit of contraction within my very deepest soul, you know, the deepest centers within myself. And a person that was with me at the time was familiar with this practice and did just very similar to that practice we just did on air. And I never ever went back to that space again. I was liberated. It was recalibrated, and I was freed of everything that had taken me to the point I was at that moment. And what I love about that prayer and what I love about that process is that there's no regret. It's saying that all of this was necessary for me to get to the point where I could not only liberate what was happening that in that specific situation, but perhaps generational and even in previous lifetimes, all of the circumstances that led to this moment in my life now to allow me the moment to set it free and to liberate myself and experience at oneness, to experience the universe within my heart and being at one with it. So Dorothy, just beautiful. What a beautiful practice.
Oh, thank you. And you know, I'm just so happy to be able to share my love of the practice and to know that it's really transforming the lives of many, many people.
And transforming, I would say, universal consciousness at the same time, as we are all representatives of that.
Absolutely. And within all the different practices throughout all the different cultures all over the world, the similarities are astounding. And, you know, it's just like drops of golden light that are just being added to, you know, this great ocean, this great sea of awareness that we are so magnificently blessed to be experiencing.
Ah, beautifully said, and a wonderful way to wrap up this show. So, Dorothy, it is always a pleasure to have you at Spirit Fire Retreat Center, and it was so great to have you on Spirit Fire Radio. We just love so many wonderful teachers and healers come through our center, and we're so blessed to be able to have them at times in certain instances on our show, and this being one of them. So thank you so much for joining us, and I hope once again that listeners will really look into this practice. It is so simple. Forgiveness is so powerful and healing, not only for ourselves, but for consciousness as in a universal sense. So once again, Ho'oponopono, go to spiritfireradio.com and you can see the write-up for this show and learn more about Dorothy Stone. So Dorothy, once again, just thank you so much for being with us, and we're going to sign off, and we hope to see you back at the center soon. And
thank you so much.
As always, thank you for everything you do.
Many blessings. Thank you.
Thank you for listening to Spirit Fire Radio. Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. Pacific Time, 12 noon Eastern, for your weekly guide to meditation and living with awareness. Join hosts Tim Darter and Steve Kramer and discover the ways that consciousness is being cultivated in everyday life. Connect to your day in a whole new way and find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio. To learn more about Spirit Fire, visit spiritfireradio.com.